So the first chapter is about development, right? You have learned a lot of terms in that. You have learned so many things. I mean, you know what do you mean by development and features of development and what do you mean by income per capita income, all these things you have learned. So I just wanted to ask you a few questions related to that. I want you to interact with me when I ask, answer. Okay, you should not be quiet. Yes.
Ma'am, your name.
My name Nina Desan. I already introduced myself before, but I think few of you were not there. So again, once more, I'm telling, I'm Nina Desan. Okay. Now coming to the topic. Development. What do you mean by development? Anyone? Can anyone say what do you mean by development? I'm asking just a simple dictionary meaning. What do you mean by that?
Improvement in life.
Improvement over the present situation. Okay. What situation we have now? Improvement happens, then we can say it is development. Okay, very good. Development, when we say we all have different meaning for that. So what one person feel that what is development for one person, it is different for others. For example, if I ask you, what is development for you in your life? You are 15 years old children. So what do you mean by or what is development in your life? What is that term meaning in your life? Anyone can start. When you feel that you will be more developed, when do you feel?
Or facilities.
Facilities. What kind of facilities? You have what you told is correct. It is general. So what facilities?
Like proper education.
Like education, then anybody else?
Clothes.
Anybody, anyone? Only one person is answering. Anybody else? What do you mean by development in your life? Vishnu Priya, what do you mean by development in your life?
Good education, health facilities, and good
Okay.
economic rate developed.
It's all big terms, I feel. Good economic, something you told. What is that good economic?
Like the country should be economically developed. It should be stable.
I'm not asking about the country. I'm asking when you will feel developed, your life.
Income should increase.
Income should increase. That means I told you before one more thing that you are 15-year-old children. So I don't think income will come here. Anything else? Something else?
More freedom.
More freedom. More free education, somebody told before. More freedom. More freedom in the sense maybe you want to go out and sit with your friends. Okay, that is development. Then that is your thinking, way of thinking. Then technologically advanced. Technologically advanced in the sense what? What do you come to that particular point? That is the answer which I want actually. Technologically advanced means what? What is the technology?
All should be able to access technologies.
What is that? Once more, you tell.
All should be able to access it.
Okay. At your age, you should be able to access the technology. I'm asking, what is the technology you want in your life? Specify. Being more satisfied with our mental physical condition, okay, that is also development. Technology, access to good health facilities, that is good. That is also correct.
I am good computers and
Good
devices.
computers, very good. That is yeah, your age if you are getting good computer rather than good computer, something else. What is that? When you feel more developed. Nobody is having
nice gadgets.
Any. Yeah, gadgets. What kind of gadgets?
Like mobile phone.
Like mobile phone or new kind of Wi-Fi connection, it can be new kind of maybe I think you can go to the extent by telling that you kind of, I mean, I don't know what games you play or all those things. You when you get, you feel more advanced and developed, right? I'm not asking only about education or anything like that. So one person told okay, if he gets mobile, he will be more developed. Another person told that if he or she is having education, more development is there. This shows what we all have different notion of development or different meaning for development. Why do we have like that? Why do we have different notions of development?
Economic status
it can be then. Or are we
mission of thinking?
Yeah, our way of thinking or our way of desire. What desire I have, the other person might have something else. Okay, so this we say that we all seek things differently. So differently we seek things, so we have different notion of development. So we have three features for development. The first one, we say that what is development for me? It may not be a development for another person. For example, somebody told that if they get a good phone, he is more developed. But one person is having the phone, he may not feel that. So what is development for the person who is getting a mobile is not same for the other person because he's already having the mobile. Okay, so development, first thing, what is development for one person? It may not be development for another person. Then you have learned in your textbook that development can be conflicting. What is the, how it will be a conflicting? Or one example is given to you in the textbook. What is that? Dam building. Other than that, one more example is given. Conflicting. My development goals are getting conflicted with somebody's development goal. What is that? Prajod. You can hear me, right? Unmute. Okay, Prajod. How or can you tell an example related to the conflicting developmental goals which is given already? Prajod, I want you to tell. You know the example? Zainaba, you know the example? Conflicting? No.
I'm building building in slum areas.
One very easy example from your life they have given in your textbook. Brother and sister. Mommy. Brother and sister, how their goals are getting conflicted. Okay. Now, did you get what I mean? Anyone? No. Okay, I'll tell you. So here, at home, brother and sister is there. Sister feels that brother is not doing any work at home, or he's not helping anything, any household work. He's not helping, but brother doesn't want to work at home. So here, the goals are conflicting. Whose goals are conflicting? Sister wants the brother to work, but brother doesn't want to work. So here the goals are conflicting. So this is an example for conflicting goals. So here you can say another feature of development. What is that? Developmental goals can be
conflicting.
Conflicting. First one, I told it will be What is that? First feature I told.
Different.
It will be different. Second one I told, conflicting. Now, third one, they have given one example. It can be destructive also. That example only you were telling before. What is that destructive here now?
Dam building.
Yeah. We are in some area, dam is going to be constructed. That area, some tribal people are living. So those people will be displaced. Displaced means what now?
Move out.
Yeah, they have to move from one area to another. I mean, they can't live there because of the construction of dams. So it is like a destruction for them. And it is beneficial for whom? Why do we construct the dams here?
For producing electricity.
So here in your textbook, it is given the electricity is going to be supplied to the industries here. Okay, so there I feel one construction of dam is beneficial for someone, construction of dam is destructive for someone. So here it is destruction for whom?
For the people living nearby.
Okay, so there you can see that it can be destructive also. So that is the third feature of development. It can be destructive also. So three features I told, what are they? First one, it will be different. Second one, it can be conflicting. Third one, it will be destructive. Now, we need a lot of things in our life. For example, maybe we need facilities, we need car, we need house, or we need mobiles or computers. Like that, so many things we want in our life. So how are we going to fulfill these wants?
Through income
or through money. Okay, so to satisfy all these things, we need money. So one important indicator of development is what? Income. Okay, or money. Now, do you think that only money is important, or can we buy everything with the help of money?
No, ma'am.
No. There are few things we can buy, only material things with the help of money. There are few things which we cannot buy with the help of money. What are they?
Love.
Okay, love, relationship, friendship, then?
Home.
House, that is what, relationship you can say. Then? I want somebody reply or interact. Only Ashik is interacting with me. All others are just like watching and sitting. I want others also to respond. Why? Others, they don't want to speak. And please switch on the videos. Let me see. I told that. Let me see you people. Yes. Why you are switching it off in between? Are you doing something else? And Prajot, I think he is busy in typing. Something is going on typing, I feel. Right? Chatting with someone? No. Okay. So Prajot, I'll call you in between to get the answer. Okay, very good. Okay, so we came to the point that income, what we are using, it is only for buying the material things. We should have some immaterial things also in our life. Like how he said, freedom or peace, happiness. Sometimes you may feel now, like how you people are sitting at home now. Okay, we are all caught up at home. We are not able to go out of the house. Your freedom is a little bit, here we can say it is not there for you. Okay, the reason is there, but that's what we have, income, money, everything. We are not able to do or we are not able to live the way how we want to live. So we don't have that much freedom to move around now because of the pandemic. So that is one thing we have to take care. It's not only that income is important. There are various other things are important in our life. That is like freedom, equality, maybe respect from others, equal treatment. We are not treated equally. You are coming to school, you're always, nobody is coming to talk to you, or you are kept separate. So you feel very bad. Even if we have a lot of income, you are not treated properly, or you are not having any, or somebody is showing some partiality, you may feel very bad. So that should not be there. So these things are also important in our life. Now, one more thing they have given in your textbook. Whenever we go for a job, the first thing what we see, that is income. Yes or no? We will see whether how much income we are going to get. That is the first thing we are going to see. Other than that, what all things we will take care of? If you are going to get a job, other than income, what all things we will take care of? Or what all things we will see?
Effort needed to do the job.
That means the kind of work what you have. Okay. Anybody else? I want others also to answer.
Whether it is good or not.
What is that?
Whether it is a good job or not.
Good job or not. What do you mean by that, good job or not? Any specification? In the sense, maybe whether it is a peaceful one or not, whether it is a dangerous one or not, it can be like that. Anything else?
Near.
Okay, nearby your house or not, or where you are staying. Anything else? Only these.
Have time to interact with the family.
Interact with the?
Family.
Family. Okay. Interact with the family. That is a better one. So here, rather than that, few more things. Whenever we are going to get a job, we will see whether we have all the facilities, whether they are providing or not, or whether they are providing any house for you to stay, or whether your children are getting some education facilities or not, or like these things, job security. What do you mean by job security? What is job security? Anyone? I couldn't hear. What is job security? Anyone? The term itself, you can get that. Job security. John Samuel, what is that?
If she's secure or not.
Secure or not means what?
It is legal.
Little more specific.
You will not lose your job.
Yeah, you are not going to lose your job. This job will be there for you for a long time. That is what you mean by job security. Okay, so that is there or not, we will see. Now, whether sometimes there is, if a situation comes like you are getting 3-4 lakhs of rupees of money as income in a month, but if they sent you to a place where your life is in danger, will you prefer to go?
No,
I don't think no one will prefer to go, because how long we will be there, how long we'll get the salary, we don't know. So all these things will be taken into consideration before accepting a job or before getting a job, other than income. Once there was a question that other than income, what all things you will take care before accepting a job here. Okay. Now, next one they have given regarding national development. When we can say that a country is developed?
The needs of the citizens are fulfilled.
When the needs of the citizens are fulfilled. Any other point? Rose? Any other point? When we can say that our country is developed?
When there is good infrastructure.
When there is good infrastructure. Okay, correct. Badra? Anything else?
When poverty is reduced.
When poverty is reduced, that means when all people are somewhat, they can live properly. Yes. Anything else? good healthcare system, that is also correct. So like this, when we can say the country is developed, when we have all the facilities. Now, the first thing to see, to know the development of a country, what is that? How can we say that this country is developed? It is income, actually. Okay, the first thing what we see mainly, that is income. Now, what do you mean by income? What do you mean by income of a country?
The flow of money.
Average.
Income of a country. Income of a family, how do you get?
The average salary.
No, I'm just asking income of a family. How do you
get? By doing job.
No. Income of a family is 1 lakh. How do you get that?
Total?
Income of the whole family.
Income of the whole family. Okay, that is what I asked. For to know the development of a country, the first point what we are taking, that is income. Okay. Now, income is what now? Income of a country is what now?
The whole income of the people.
Once more.
The whole income of the people living in that country.
Whole income of the people living in a country. That means the income of all the residents of a country. That is what total income. Now, total income can be taken as an indicator for development. That is the question. Total income means what? You know what is total income? Savio, who is Savio? Yeah, just show your face. Savio, are you there? Or you slept?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Savio, what do you mean by total income? It's lagging. Can you put that answer in the chat box?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Surya, can you tell me what is total income?
Can you repeat the question?
What do you mean by total income of a country?
The total amount received to the total amount of people.
Okay, total amount of people, in the sense total income of population, that is what you mean by total income of a country. Now, this total income, we cannot take as an indicator for development. What is the reason? I told that to see whether the country is developed or not. We say that India is not much developed. America is developed. So we are comparing here. We are comparing here. But total income, we cannot take as an indicator. What is the reason? Somebody told. Who is that? Why can't we use?
Because of the population.
Because of the population. Now, you know the population. Mainly because of population. We can't take total income as an indicator for development. Reason is what? Population may be in some countries it is very high, in some countries it is very low. So there is a chance that even being a poor country, if the population is very high, if you total it up, the total income may be high for that country. So we can't take. So the next one comes, then what we can take? That is what you were telling, that is average income or per capita income. Now, what do you mean by per capita income? Average, you know. How you find average, you know. How do you find average?
Population by income.
Is it?
The number of added by the outcomes.
No, you just think of maths. How do you find average? How do you get average?
Income by population.
Income by population, that is the correct one. In the sense, total by number. This is how you get the average, right? total by number. Whatever total is there divided by number, you get the average. The same way, we are getting average income of a country. That means how we are finding average income? Total income. Yeah, total income divided by
population.
Population, you get the average income. That is the same as per capita income, per person's income of a particular country. On an average, we say that this is the income of a person in our country. That is what you mean by per capita income. Now, per capita income, they have given in your textbook, they have given that World Bank uses per capita income for comparison, comparing between the countries that you might have learned. Yes? Just 1 minute. Yes, here you can see you have your textbook also with you. World Bank is classifying the countries into two they have given in your textbook. Other than this, we can say that middle income group also. Okay, so two classifications they have given. What kind of countries are called as rich countries?
With more capital income.
With more capital. In your textbook, it is given clearly. You can see that. Just see what is the amount they have given.
US
955.
Is it? US dollar 12,056
per annum. That means if a country's per capita income is US dollar 12,056 per annum and above, those countries we call them as what kind of countries? Developed or rich countries, we say. Okay. Now, there are some other countries whose per capita income, which is less than 955, we call them as. What is the term we are using here?
Underdeveloping.
Low income countries. That is what the term they have given in your textbook. Okay. So, use that. Now, they have given India's per capita income. Just see how much is India's per capita income. I think you can see the screen. You can see the screen, right? Textbook page you can see, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so in that you can see India's per capita income. What is India's per capita income?
120 per annum.
1,820 per annum. So see, India's per capita income is this much. Where do we stand? We are in rich countries or we are in low income country?
Middle class.
Okay. So it is, we call them as middle income group company. Okay. So we are in middle income group because we are in between. So what is the definition for middle income country? What is the definition for middle income country? Low income country, you know. Rich income country, you know. So what is the definition for middle income?
Neither rich nor poor.
And rich,
neither it's rich not poor. Like that. You have to use these terms. The countries whose per capita income between US dollar 12,056 to US dollar 955, we call them as middle income. You got what I said? Here they have given you rich income countries also and low income countries also. So middle income, how to say that? It is between 955 and 12,056 per annum. That much US dollar, if you falls in between that, that country belongs to middle income. That is why we say that India is in middle income group. Now, one more thing they have given here related to India. India is in low middle income group. What is that low middle income group? Are we near to the 12,000 or are we near to 9,555?
We are near to 955.
because of that, we are in the group of low middle income group. We are not nearing the upper area. We are near to the 955. That's why we say 955. Now, so this is one method to compare the countries, that is per capita income. Why it's not coming? Just 1 minute.